Good afternoon to everyone. Myself, Deepika Kakkar, I'm here presenting a review article on bite marks and indispensable physical evidence in rape cases. Next. It's a physical alteration in a medium caused by any contact, by the contact of the teeth. It's a representative pattern left by any object or a tissue by the dental structure of any animal or a human being. So it is, if we talk about a cutaneous bite mark, it is an injury caused in skin by contacting a teeth, which shows the representation pattern of the oral structure. ABFO has defined these bite marks as a pattern left in any object or tissue by the dental structure of any animal or a human. Next slide, please. So if we now consider about the historical of the bite marks, how that bite marks become very important as an collaborative evidences with other evidences like DNA and fingerprint. It was the earliest first recorded bite mark case in the USA was Oyo versus Robinson in 1870, in which Ansel Robinson was suspected of murdering his mistress, Mary Lonwin. His teeth matched with the bite marks on the victim's.
Deepika, you are not able to hear you. Can you unmute?
Sir, now I'm audible.
Audible. Please turn off the video so that you will get the good bandwidth.
Yeah. Next was the Ted Bundy case, in which raped and killed more than 30 women, who was convicted of rape and a murder of Lisa Levy and a Martin Baum. He even left a bite mark on a Lisa Levy buttock. So these were the two important cases where the bite marks analysis became a very important. Now it's about the classification of the bite mark. Classification was done on accordingly three types: Cameron and Sims classification, in which one was the agent, in which human and the animal. Second was the material, skin, body tissue, body stuff. Second was McDonald's classification, in which he has considered the tooth and the tongue. Tooth is the tooth pressure marks and the tooth scrap marks. And third was the tongue pressure marks. And next was it was on the basis of the degree of impression, how much the bite marks have left the impression. It was whether it should be the clearly defined, obviously defined, quite noticeable and lacerated. Next slide, please. Now, even if we consider on the classification of human bite marks, it was also classified in many categories. One is the abrasion, that is the scrap on the skin, hemorrhages, undamaging mark on the skin, contusion, if there is a rupture of the blood vessels or the any kind of a bruise we see. Next is an incision. It is just like a nearing the puncturing of the skin, laceration, totally puncturing of or torning of the skin, like skin hemorrhages. Third is avulsion, complete removal of the skin, artifacts, bitten of the piece of the skin, incision or avulsion artifacts. Next slide, please. There are many factors affecting the bite marks. First is the site variation, on which part or on which location of the bite marks has occurred. That is, it varies from person to person, and it even varies from the mechanical properties of the tissues also. Like example, if we take the tissue of the breast are innately softer than those of the other parts of the body or the those of the back. Next is the directional variation. It is at any given side due to pre-existing tension lines in the skin is known, which are known as the Langer lines. There can be flexion, extension, and rotation of these surface skin marking follow the pattern of these lines. There are many other factors also, like how the surface has been bitten, how the dragging of during the biting process, how much dragging it has taken, structure and vascularity of the tissue, any kind of a medication is done on it, environmental factors. And fourth factor is the clothing. Though which the bite mark is inflicted affects the injury to some extent. The age of the injury in the time elapsed from the inflection to the analysis and the damaged tissue. Next slide, please. Now, how is the mechanism, how the bite mark is done? Bite mark usually occurs due to the pressure of the teeth on the skin. It is basically a combined by the mandibular closure and the suction of the skin, or we can say it causes a negative pressure. Upper jaw is usually stationary and it holds and stretches the skin, and the lower jaw is movable and it gives the most biting force. Means that the lower jaw actually helps in biting, it helps give the biting force. And human bite, as we know, it is an elliptical or the circular injury with specific characteristics of the tip. If there is a single C-shaped mark, then only one jaw was involved in that bite mark, and the diameter of the injury basically ranges from 25 to 40 mm. Next slide. Now, there are many bite mark patterns, means our teeth give different types of the bite marks. There are the class characteristics also, and there are the individual characteristics. Class characteristics will be covering whole the population will be as the similar patterns will be there. And the individual, there may be a difference. Individual characteristics are the individual teeth have the individual type of impression, or we can say different type of a bite mark. The two upper central incisors are wide and the lateral incisors are narrow and cuspids are cone-shaped. And the upper jaw is usually wider than the lower jaw. And the character, there are the different characteristics of the different teeth. As we can see, incisors are rectangular shaped mark. And basically they are, they give the perforation of the at the incisal angles area. Canines form the triangular types of bite marks. They give the triangular markings with apex towards labial and base towards the lingual. Premolars, they usually give the single or the dual triangle with the bases of triangles facing each other or coming together as a in the form of a diamond shape. Molars, they usually rarely leave the bite mark. Usually, if they leave the bite mark, they will always form the quadrilateral types of marking. Next slide, please. Now, there is a very important role come how the bite mark investigation should be done. First, so there was a scientist, Raymond and Melton, as well as a Swede, they have emphasized that there should be an attempt of a bite mark investigation should begin with the following question. First should be, we should know, is this an injury, a bite mark or not? This is a bite, was it is caused by the human teeth or by any other source? Or was it caused by a adult or a child? There is a difference between the adult as well as the child bite mark also. Does the age of the bite mark correspond to the time and the type of the crime scene? Next, are there any unique individual characteristics in the bite mark? Or can these characteristics can be compared to the teeth of the suspect? These questions should be considered while doing any kind of a, especially the bite mark investigation. Next slide. So to standardize this investigation and to consider the bite mark analysis, the American Board of Forensic Odontology has established the following guidelines in 1986. And these guidelines, first should be that we should know the history of the bite mark. Second, the photography of the bite mark should be done very carefully, because it will be the evidences that would be taken consider in the trial of the court. Third, then we should consider the external oral examination, where the soft tissue and the hard tissue factors which actually influence the dynamic of the biting should be considered, and the measurement of the maximum opening and any kind of a deviation taken at the time of opening or the closing of the teeth should be considered. Next should be the interoral examination, where we will be swabbing from the DNA or the saliva. Then the DNA analysis will be considered. Next is the impression. The two impressions which are caused by the each arch using the material, that should be met to the criteria by the American Dental Association specification. And their relationship should be recorded for the further proceedings. Next, sample bites. Means the sample of the suspect bite in the centric occlusion using a wafer, base plate, wax or the silicon puffy material should be. And those the suspected sample should be properly photographed with proper scaling of with scaling of those suspect bite marks for the
I think there is some technical issue she is facing. She'll join again. We can wait for 1 minute.
Next slide, please. Am I audible? Now, the very main important for any investigation of the bite marks is the photographing of the bite mark. This is a very, very important step using the bite marks analysis. And in the rape cases, this is very important. As we can say in the rape cases, in the victim's body, we used to saw many kind of a bite marks at the different areas of the suspected body. In this, we can use a digital camera instead of the traditional, which allows the odontologist to reduce the margin of error, and all the life size dimension of the photograph is recreated. If much time lapse of if the bite mark is started, it's going down, then the alternative photograph method using the UV light can be used to make the images of the tips of the penetrated area. Next slide. Now, how to compare a suspected bite mark with the victim's body? According to American Board of Forensic Odontology 1994, the most widely used method for the comparison of the bite marks evidence are the generation of overlays. Next. Or the test bite media, example, the wax explainer styrofoam. Recently, many software has even used being Adobe Photoshop is being used to compare the dental profile of the bite mark. With this use, transparent overlays can be created, which are then laid over the bite marks, which the suspected bite mark. The advantage of using the computerized system are accurate, as it can give you the accurate measure of the physical parameter of the evidence, less photographic distortion, eliminates the examiner's subjectivity, good image visualization, standardization of comparison procedure, and reproducibility of the result. Next slide. So how the now it's a very important question, how we can collect the bite marks in the rape cases. First, we should know whenever we are collecting the bite mark, what the demographics plays a very important role, means the name, age, sex, race, and the case number and the date of the examination and the who has examined should be properly recorded for the future proceedings. Next is the location of the bite mark, from where we have taken the bite marks, their photographs, even the cast if we are creating should be taken properly, where we should describe the anatomical location. We should indicate the contour of the surface, whether it is in the flat shape, curved or the irregular. We should even define it properly, the state of the tissue. If, what is the condition of the tissue? What is the state of the tissue? Curvature also, the different characteristics of the tissue. When the bite marks and collection evidence is taken care, underlining the tissue, bone, cartilage, muscles or fat, etc. Even the shape of the bite marks plays a very important role, whether it is in the round shape, ovoid, crescent or irregular. It should be properly documented. Next, color and the size of the bite mark also play. We should see it is a vertical or a horizontal dimension should be recorded with the metric system, means proper scaling should be considered. And now the type of the injury due to bite marks can be petechial hemorrhages, contusion, abrasion, laceration, incision, evolution, artifact. They should be properly noted down, properly documentation, because in the chain of custody, these parameters will be considered very important for the future proceeding. Next slide, please. So I would like to conclude by saying this, that the importance of bite marks basically provides a valuable information in nailing a rape accused, because it is fact on the majority of the rapists leave bite marks on their victim's body. And these bite marks carry a very high forensic value because they are based on the different characteristics that are similar to the defender, and they can be very conclusive with the other evidences like DNA and fingerprint evidences in the rape cases. And with the technological advances and the use of the UV lighting to detect the human bite marks on the rape, it has proved to be the booming industry. And to conclude, I would likely say that while the criminal may lie through his teeth, his bite marks reveal all and do not lie. Thank you.